happen again and again and again. It is making sure that we lay the groundwork so that our Canadian government cannot come out with shameful statements. Always, it has been always for the last 6 years that Harper has been in power, the first international entity to come out and say Israel is right. There is nothing to say about Israel. Our battle is here before it is on the shores of the Mediterranean or before it becomes on the ground in Gaza. Our battle is here with our shameful, with our Zionist government that has no conscience about crying for the blood of children that is spilled, that does totally brainwash or tries to brainwash in its words the people's minds by making them believe there are two powers fighting there when there is the fourth strongest army in the world bombarding a civilian population. How can we be quiet about that? Why are we only angry about it when it happens, while when we are knowing that it's going to happen, at least, if not in the next week, in the next month, or the next year, we can lay back and relax? We shouldn't. As long as Harper is in power, we shouldn't. As long as these governments in the Western world that don't want to face the truth, that only look for the economic gain and brainwash people, we shouldn't. It's not only for ourselves, it's for the blood of those children that is built in Gaza. And I am sure that we will get the best out of the situation right now, and we will one more time strengthen the movement to make things better locally and thus internationally. Thank you very much for having me here, and I hope to get the chance to see you tonight in the mosque as well, talking about our work with the Gaza.
I think Curtis